Airplanes kind of look like airplanes. So we're looking for an image of an airplane.
No, this isn't the search for Malaysian Airlines Flight 370. In fact, we're far from it here. This is Lake Michigan, following along with a team of salvagers and divers on the verge of locating a big find of their own.
The worse the crash is, the more the restorers like it because it proves how good they are. They put it back together.
The depth of Lake Michigan, not more than several hundred feet in this area. The team uses sonar to find the exact location, and within a matter of minutes.
Right there. Boom, right there. See it? Oh, yeah. Mother. Look at that.
They find what they're looking for.
Drop the buoy.
Divers drop in and take us down below. They capture these stunning images of a World War II bomber that crashed into Lake Michigan nearly half a century ago. The visibility here good, partly because the zebra mussels that now coat the plane also help filter the fresh water. Underneath them, a piece of American history.
The pieces are there, but about 100 feet apart. The engine sank first right away. The other part floated a little bit.
Back then, the Great Lakes served as a training ground for aircraft carriers and pilots learning to land on the short runways. This SBD Dauntless dive bomber crashed, though the pilot survived. Salvage expert Taras Lysenko hopes to raise money to raise the plane and put it on display in Chicago.
You show one of these things a six-year-old, the first time they see him, their eyes just light up. They don't have to know what it is. They know it's important.
A successful mission, finding this submerged plane, though the team reflects on the differences and complexities of the much bigger search for Flight 370 that's garnered international intrigue.
When you're down into thousands of feet deep, the pressures are astronomical. These things are unbelievably expensive. The cables for sonar systems are unbelievably long. If they even found that aircraft, to lift that structure is unbelievably difficult.
And unlike the search here on Lake Michigan, Lysenko believes it's the uncertainty about exactly where Flight 370 went down that may serve as the biggest challenge to search crews for many, many years to come.
Oh, I think somebody someday is gonna, you know, but it might be a couple hundred years from now, you know, and technology gets better and at some point they might have a technology that's able to actually pinpoint.
One thing this team knows with certainty, persistence and patience do eventually pay off on these waters. The bigger question, though, for a much bigger search on the other side of the world is when? George Howell, CNN, Chicago.